Well, the RBA was doing a bit of that flexing yesterday, right? What do you make of it all?
Yeah, look, it really did flex its muscle yesterday, didn't it, Carl? The RBA. Look, almost no one was predicting this 11th interest rate rise in 12 meetings. Now, there's three main reasons for it. First of all, the RBA says inflation's still too high, although it's coming down at 7%. It's particularly worried about inflation in the services sector, which has hit a two-decade high. Secondly, house prices are on the rise again after it signalled that interest rate pause. Now, it's worried that that'll make homeowners feel wealthier, spend more money and add to inflation pressures. And third, the labour market. Unemployment's very low at 3.5% and wages are rising without productivity offsets in the labour market. So they're worried wages are going to spill into inflation. So that's why we've had the cash rate go to 3.85%.
Do you think there's anything behind this rate rise, John? I mean, is this a bit of an affront to Jim Chalmers? It's certainly going to make his job more difficult next week.
Yeah, well, as Jim Chalmers, the Treasurer, said himself, it's a brutal reminder ahead of the budget. The number one sort of task is to bring down inflation. And this is a tricky task for Chalmers because he's under all sorts of pressure from Labor backbenchers, welfare groups as well, to increase job seeker, rent assistance, assistance for single mums and things like that. He did say yesterday there will be cost of living relief in the budget. We're expecting household energy relief, childcare subsidies and cheaper medicines. But how far he goes on that other stuff, that's going to be really key for inflation, because if he opens the floodgates, which I don't think he will, but if he did, that would really add to inflation pressures. So he's got to show restraint next week.
The R word keeps surfacing too now.
Yeah, well, Deloitte says the RBA's playing recession roulette, Carl, and AMP also uses the potential for recession as well. So, look, we've had a steep rise in interest rates. Philip Lowe last night in Perth said it's a real balancing act. There's still this narrow path to avoid recession, but you get the sense that it's getting very narrower.
That's for sure. Good on you, Johnny. Thank you.
Well, in a shock move, the RBA has raised rates yet again after last month's brief pause. Aussies now hoping the upcoming budget will go some way to addressing the cost of living crisis. For more, we're joined by Treasurer Jim Chalmers in Canberra. Treasurer, good morning. Thanks so much for your time today. Now, this, of course, was a very big call from the Reserve Bank Governor yesterday. Philip Lowe caught a lot of analysts off guard, some of them saying that it might have even been pretty vindictive because of your changes to the RBA. What do you make of it?
Oh, I obviously don't agree with that last part of their analysis. It caught the market by surprise. That happens rarely, but it can happen. The market got it wrong yesterday. I think it was a pretty blunt, pretty brutal reminder of the challenges in our economy, particularly this inflation challenge, which your viewers are feeling every day as they feel these cost of living pressures. And that's really the main focus of the budget that I'll be handing down in less than a week's time, to try and help people deal with some of these cost of living pressures, prioritising the most vulnerable Australians, and trying to provide that relief in a way that doesn't add to this inflationary challenge that we have in our economy.
Yeah, Treasurer, that pressure's really been around for 12 months now and it hasn't really alleviated. The opposition is saying this hike shows the RBA has no confidence in your government.
Well, the worst quarter for inflation was actually the March quarter last year when they were still in office. They handed down a budget that had no savings. They had $1 trillion in debt with almost nothing to show for it. They had hundreds of billions of dollars of deficits. All nine of their budgets that they handed down were in deficit. And so I don't think people take the opposition especially seriously when they make these kind of comments, given their record. And the truth is that it will take more than one budget, more than two budgets, to clean up the mess that the Liberals left us.
Millions of Australians around the country are paying upwards of $10,000 extra each year because of these rate increases. I mean, how much has your mortgage gone up? Are you feeling the pain?
Oh, it's not about me, Sarah. I'm not going to get into that. Obviously, I do recognise that a lot of Australians are under the pump, and when interest rates go up, it makes life even harder, and that's why cost of living is such a big focus of the budget. It's why we're making medicines cheaper. It's why we're making childcare cheaper. It's why we're providing some help with energy bills in the budget. And it's why there will be other elements to our cost of living relief plan, which will be responsible. It will be targeted particularly to the most vulnerable Australians. But most of all, it will recognise that people are doing it tough right now. The government understands that and we will respond to that in the budget.
Yeah, there's going to have to be a lot of savings to be found for these families. I mean, this is sounding a lot like a game of recession roulette. Economists are warning it could be.
Oh, well, I'm not obviously not going to get into that kind of language, but the Reserve Bank, the Treasury and the market economists all expect the Australian economy to slow later this year. It's a consequence of what's happening in the global economy, but also the impact of these rate rises that are already in the system.
So you don't see a recession ahead?
Oh, that's not something we're anticipating, not something that the Treasury will be forecasting in the budget. The budget won't have an expectation that the Australian economy will go backwards, but it will say that, consistent with all of these other forecasts, that the Australian economy will slow considerably. And we need to take that into account as well. The budget will be a difficult balancing act between providing the cost of living relief that people need, being conscious of the pressures on the budget and all of that debt that we inherited, but also making sure that we can grow our way out of this slowing economy by investing in things like energy and and laying some of these foundations for growth in our economy.
Yeah, I mean, it's a huge challenge ahead, and the problem is that Australians are the ones copping it. You know, you talk about migration housing, it's just mounting all the time. I mean, there's speculation the government will increase the job seeker allowance, but only to those over 55. I mean, why that age cohort? I mean, basic grocery costs are the same regardless of someone's age, and probably younger generations are going to have to pay for families as well.
Well, my advice to all of your viewers, Sarah, is to tune in on Tuesday night and see across the board the cost of living relief that we will be providing. There's always speculation in the lead up to the budget. Sometimes it's right, sometimes
it's
not right.
Give them something today,
Treasurer.
I mean, they've had that awful news yesterday from the Reserve Bank. Is there anything you can tease right now?
Well, I can assure your viewers, Sarah, that there will be substantial cost of living relief in the budget. It'll prioritise the most vulnerable. It won't just be limited by age, and it will be responsible.
And rather than increase job seeker, any hope for helping them find jobs?
Oh, a big part of our focus. You know, we've got unemployment at 3.5%. We want to make it easier for people to grab the opportunities in the labour market and try and make sure that people can get good, secure, well-paid jobs. That's a big part of our focus, and you'll see that in the budget too.
Yeah, I guess the challenge is pushing up inflation by increasing job seeker, but we'll see how it plays out. Thanks so much for your time, Treasurer.
Well, for his take, Westpac Chief Economist Bill Evans joins us now from Sydney. Bill, clearly economists don't know as much as the RBA boss.
Well, Carl, it came as a bit of a surprise, I must admit. His assessment of the inflation risks changed pretty quickly over the last few weeks. I think he was concerned about the lift in services inflation, and I think the stability in the housing market unnerved him as well.
OK, so the RBA doesn't seem to care about hard-working Aussies, right?
No, they do. They realise that if we don't get this inflation under control, it's going to be a lot worse for Aussies further down the track, and we've seen examples of that back in the 70s and 80s when interest rates had to go to double digits and stay there, and we had an unemployment rate of 12%. They want to avoid that. They want to get on the front foot. And they're more nervous about inflation than they have been. And so that suggests that that's why they've got this tightening bias. In other words, they're talking about potential for further hikes.
I think it's hard for Australians to draw a bead on it. When you see inflation coming down, we saw yesterday 100% of economists come out and say there was no need for it. They didn't think it was going to happen. And then it happens. That level of accountability, that level of understanding is shattered.
Well, things are moving so quickly, Carl. I think that's the issue. The Reserve Bank of the US is going to raise rates this week. I think that was a signal for them. The inflation numbers, as you say, were better than expected, but the part of the inflation that around the world has proved to be hard to control, which is services inflation, was still very strong, up 6% for the year. And I think that's what unnerved them, and that's what we underestimated in our assessment, that they'd be happy to hold for another month and get some more information.
Tricky for the government with inflation to hand out more in the budget. Are you worried about recession?
Oh, look, our growth rate is 1% this year. The government did, the RBA did have 1.7. They came down to less than that. And yesterday they came down to 1.25. I think in the second half of this year, the economy will basically stagnate. Because bear in mind that we have this huge, what we call this cliff of people moving from fixed rate to floating rate. So when they do that, they go up from 2 and 3 up to 4, 5 and 6. So you're basically going to have a year where interest rates are rising, even if the RBA goes on hold.
Wow.
Now, we think they will be on hold from here, but the risks are greater than they were before.
And the banks will still pass it on. Did you get that?
I'm sorry?
And the banks will still pass it on, though?
The banks will be making their decisions in the next few days, without doubt.